afternoon comes these cool. Welcome. You guys, that's the presentation this afternoon. I'd like to thank all the parents in our audience for coming out. Thank you for taking the time out of your busy day to come watch this today. I'm sure this will be a big treat for you as well. I'd like to first of all put a round of applause for our musical guest this past week, Fubuki Daiko. So big thank you to all the students that have worked with them. I'm sure it's been quite an experience. So I'll let them introduce the first group themselves.
Thank you very much. The first class performing for you is Mrs. Sanderson's grade 4 class. They are going to play a song called the Kenny Endo Song. Kenny Endo is a taiko drummer who we trained with. He is based currently in Hawaii. He's originally from Los Angeles. He went to Japan and spent 10 years studying taiko there, and he taught us this song. This is the Kenny Endo Song, grade 4, Mrs. Anderson's class. Have fun, guys.
Thank you. Next group is coming up is Mrs. Young's grade 4 group. The piece they're going to be doing is called the Dokodon Trade-Off. For those of you who aren't familiar with what Dokodon means, basically the way we learn our music is by singing the song. Each sound of the drum has a specific word to it. So a don or doko means basically a loud hit. And so this is the basic lines that are used. So this is a trade-off between two groups. I'm going to call it the Dokodon trade-off. So this is the grade four for Mrs. Young's group.
Thank you.
They're going to be performing a piece called Isami Goma. Isami Goma literally means galloping horses. It was a piece adapted by our teacher's teacher, Grandmaster Daihachi Oguchi from Nagano Prefecture. This was based on a 250-year-old song. And again, this is a piece called Galloping War Horses, so there's going to be a little bit of imagery in terms of battle scenes. At one point, they'll be bringing their arms up like that. That will impersonate the view of samurai warriors on horseback with swords. Also, there'll be also increasing spears as well. At the very end, they're also going to be impersonating. You've noticed that they'll be bringing their arms out, and that's supposed to replicate the birds or cranes flying from the fields as the horses are galloping through the fields. And at the very end, it will be doing a little bit of a flick, and that represents the horse's tail. So this is Isami Goma.
Five class. They are going to play a song which is called Matsuri Daiko. Matsuri means festival in English. And this is a type of song, a rhythm that is played throughout Japan, particularly during the summer, when there are lots of festivals happening from town to town across the country. This piece usually has lots of dancing, so there's lots of movement in this piece that you'll see. And it's very festive, because it's a festival. Hope you enjoy it. This is Matsuri Daiko.
Thank you.
who helped to organize the logistics and all the details for our program, for us to come here and work with the kids for a week. It takes a lot of figuring out with school schedules, swimming and everything, so thanks a lot for all your hard work. We'd also like to thank the Manitoba Arts Council. They helped to fund this program through your taxpayer dollars. Without their support, we wouldn't be able to go across Manitoba and do this with students. We were able, fortunately, also to be in Snow Lake last week, thanks to them. I will also mention that coming up in October in Winnipeg, our group, Fubuki Daiko, is having a 20th anniversary concert. It's going to be a big extravaganza. We're going to have at least 15 people on stage and all of our big drums. So if you have friends or family in Winnipeg or might be down there yourself during October 21st, 22nd, or 23rd, come and check out our show. It's at the Gas Station Arts Center in Osborne Village. The last piece that we're going to play for you, Hiroshinai, is called Nida Nushi, which means beating on two sides of the drum. This is a style of playing that was developed in Japan in the late 50s, early 1960s by a group called Skedokun Taiko. This group invented a stand that puts the drum at a 45 degree angle, allows for some different types of movements and different ways of playing it. The piece starts off with some set choreography, and then it becomes a solo piece where each drummer takes turns making up what they want to do a basic backbeat rhythm. Thanks again very much for having us up here at Kelsey School. We had a fantastic time. Domo arigato gozaimashita.
Especially our PAC,
Parent Advisory Council, so thank you. You helped fund some of this, and I'm making it happen. We appreciate all the budget support, our whole community. Thank you. And I have a little thank you gift for Roshi. So how about one more big applause for the everybody else, if you can make your way back to your class, thank you.